Hi everyone, this is Karen from the Historical Society of Montgomery County, Pennsylvania. We're so thrilled this month's video, we are partnering with the Wissahickon Valley Historical Society. They were kind enough to let us come here to the Franklinville School here in Bluebell, Pennsylvania. The Franklinville School is currently the only former one-room schoolhouse that is still standing to this day and is not a private residence or a business. It is on the National Register of Historic Places, and the Wissahickon Valley Historical Society has been working really hard to make improvements and repairs to this structure. The school was built in 1858 and was used until 1916. In 1916, it closed when the Whitpain Consolidated School formed on West Skipack Pike. In 1917, the year after the school closed, the building and property around it was bought by Ralph and May Strausberger. They wanted to use this building to help educate their son, Peter. By 1925, the Strausbergers no longer needed to use the school as a school. So they then transferred it as a meeting place for Strausberger's 50-year club. And basically what that club was were people who were subscribers to the Times Herald, which was the newspaper owned by Strausberger, and they lived in the county for at least 50 years, they could enroll to be members of this club. So this location was actually a meeting place where they would come and celebrate and socialize on the grounds. By the 1980s, the 50-year club was no longer meeting here. The building was owned by Peter Strausberger, and it had fallen into disrepair because it was not being used for anything at that time. In the 1980s, when Peter Strausberger could no longer maintain this building, local residents who wanted to revitalize the building approached him, and he gave them the okay to start restoring it back to its former glory. In 1983, the Whitpain Historical Society officially formed. Local residents who wanted to preserve the township's history decided to approach Peter Strausberger, and they did work together to restore the schoolhouse. They used bake sales, attic sales, plant sales, any kind of fundraising mechanisms they could use to raise money to make repairs that the building desperately needed at the time. Some of the work they did included patching and painting walls, cleaning, repairing and replacing windows and shutters as needed. And they even installed electricity and replaced the floorboards. By 1997, the building was owned by a developer who was kind enough to donate the schoolhouse to the Historical Society. Once it was officially donated to the Historical Society, the roof was replaced, a non-functioning potbelly stove was donated and installed in the center of the building, and desks and artifacts were placed inside of the building to help give the current population an idea of what the school used to look like back in the mid to late 1800s and very early 1900s. In 2014, the Franklinville School was added to the National Register of Historic Places. So it is preserved as a historic landmark right here in Montgomery County. And although there are other one-room schoolhouses that still stand to this day, because they're all private residences and they're not owned by a historical society like this one, they did not get the same backing to apply for this national registration designation. So that makes this school particularly unique in that it's the only one-room schoolhouse in our county that is on the National Register. In 2015, the Whippen Historical Society did become part of the Wissahickon Valley Historical Society. The two societies merged. So now they collectively work together to maintain this historic site. The Wissahickon Valley Historical Society has been working tirelessly to continue preserving this site. They rely on a lot of volunteers, the local Boy Scouts, and individuals who donate money, time, and resources to make repairs as needed and to further promote the preservation of this unique historic site. Currently, there are still a lot of renovations that still need to be done so that they can officially reopen this site to be viewed by the public. So the Wissahickon Valley Historical Society is currently raising money to make these much needed renovation projects. They have been extremely thankful to have received a lot of funds already, and a lot of their projects have already been created and finished, but they still have a long ways to go. So far, as of 2021, some of the grant money they received from a Pennsylvania legislative grant offered by the Keystone Communities Program with the help of local representative Liz Hanbich, they were able to add a new electrical panel, improve the drainage system underneath the buildings so the floors don't flood, and waterproofing the foundation. So all of that has already been done. However, they still have a need to raise money to do rewiring, to make sure everything's up to code and is safe. They need to replace the roof, and they need a new HVAC system. They need to paint, since a lot of these renovations had not been done since the 1980s. They do need to upgrade all of this stuff to make it look nice and also be safe for the public to view. They also want to renovate and replace both the front and back porches. The front porch is made of wood and was last replaced in the 1980s. And as you can see, it's very weak in certain spots. So in order to make it safe for people to walk on it, they do need to replace it so that it can support folks. And the back was brick put onto concrete, and it sagged and gave way in some places. So they do need to raise money to replace that as well. Once all of these renovations are complete, the Wissahickon Valley Historical Society plans to reopen this schoolhouse for local functions and so that the public can come in and see what it was like to attend a one-room schoolhouse at that time. For anyone who wishes to contribute either their time, make a financial donation, or even just share this story, we encourage you to go to the Wissahickon Valley Historical Society's homepage that has all the information about how you can get involved to help further preserve this historic site. I want to thank the Wissahickon Valley Historical Society for giving us this special access to this building while they're in the midst of all these renovation projects. And we look forward to seeing the amazing work they're continuing to do here at the Franklinville School.